Dear viewers, we, the JPIC members of St. Mary's Convent Intercollege Lucknow, would like to extend a warm welcome to you all. It's very strange and so different that now, whenever we interact, we have some kind of screen in between us. Sometimes the screen of a digital platform, sometimes of a mask, and sometimes of a face shield. A couple of years ago, terms like quarantine, social distancing, self-isolation were alien to us. But now, they have entered our lives and have become a necessary evil. The pandemic has compelled the Homo sapiens to battle for certain resources which are normally available for free. The microorganism, which has been baptized as Corona, is not visible to us, but the kind of devastation and grief that it causes makes even a stranger's sorrow palpable. This virus impinges not only on the physical deterioration of a patient, but also works as a catalyst in the path leading to a healthy person's abysmal mental health.
The year 2020 and 2021 has posed innumerable challenges for people of all ages and from all walks of life. Whether we talk about the unending duty shifts of doctors and nurses, the challenges faced by the migrating laborers, or the education system, where the teachers are stuck in the mesh of the internet and the students are trapped in the web of the online classes. Life has entered such a tunnel, the end of which can still not be seen.
COVID-19 has turned the world upside down and brought our lives to a standstill. But this virus has made us realize that petty divides don't matter at all. We see the vast majority of people demonstrating their best of humanity and giving us real hope as we strive to bring an end to the pandemic. Their generosity of spirit, compassion and kindness are reducing illness and relieving the suffering brought on by COVID-19. The long-lost relationships have come alive, with people helping their neighbors in simple acts of grace, such as delivering groceries, running errands, and calling them to keep up spirits and offer connection. The public perception towards police personnel and doctors has improved drastically. Some NGOs and organizations are trying their best to feed stray animals and help economically downtrodden people in maintaining their livelihood. Thus, humanity has come alive with the flashes of hope, positivity, and the efforts of our COVID-19 warriors, which actually has infused more hope in the dying society.
Yes. The entire human race has been grappling amidst the challenges of this pandemic. We have suffered a lot and are still suffering. But there is one thing that we have always clasped onto, and that is hope. Hope of a better future tomorrow. If you watch around carefully, there is hope oozing from innumerable sources.
With the cries of every newborn baby, there is hope.
With the growth of every new plant, there is hope.
Every flower that blossoms, there is hope.
With every patient recovering from COVID, there is hope.
With the laughter of joy and reunion of the families resonating in the air, there is hope.
With every bright ray of the sun, each day, there is hope.
Now, it is on us to decide what we want to hold on to, crisis or hope.
Together, we can do it. Let us have faith in the Almighty and hold on to hope.
God is our creator, God is the way. can make a change if we put our hands together. We'll find a way. Justice, peace, integrity, that's what we strive for. Years of inequality now will be no more. Peace is all we seek and love is all we spread. With your gracious hands you bind us with the same thread. We will change the world and